You're watching WDSU News Channel 6 on your side.
We begin tonight with breaking news. Just in the past 30 minutes, the man in charge of the FBI in New Orleans has retired. James Bertazzani was a key figure in many corruption investigations, but came under fire just a few weeks ago when he suggested during a WDSU interview that he was considering a run for public office.
And shortly after our story aired, higher-ups in Washington transferred Bertazzani to Washington. But it now appears he's decided not to accept that assignment and instead leave the FBI. Mark Gant will now serve as the acting special agent in charge. And tonight on News Channel 6 at 10 o'clock, we'll talk to Bertazzani about his future and if it involved politics.
And now to tonight's big local story. The housing crisis hits home in one upscale New Orleans neighborhood.
Dozens of homes are up for sale, but buyers aren't making any offers. And real estate agents say it's a local example of a national financial problem.
In the first quarter of 2006, there were more than 210,000 foreclosures. By the first quarter of this year, banks had taken over nearly 650,000 homes in just 3 months.
And New Orleans is no exception.
Tonight, WDSU anchor LaTanya Norton shows us one subdivision in the middle of a mortgage meltdown. She's on your side with tonight's big local story.
With the nation's economy in a slump and millions of Americans affected by the subprime mortgage crisis, even upscale communities like English Turn are feeling the pinch.
With its Jack Nicklaus design golf course, country club facilities, and luxurious homes and villas, English Turn, a premier master plan community, is hit for the first time ever with property foreclosure.
We had some other problems with like subprime meltdown, insurance issues here in Louisiana that are specific to us. But it's just a matter of, I think it's an imbalance right now between suppliers, between sellers and buyers.
Homes at English Turn range from $450,000 to more than $1 million. Right now, 39 of English Turn's 460 homes are on the market.
Certainly, we have a large supply of houses, and we're looking for buyers to purchase houses all over. And I think in that price range that you see in English Turn, you'll see in just about any price range anywhere in the city, you're going to see the same situation.
The high-end market is always the last one to come back, of course.
New Orleans City Councilwoman and licensed realtor Jackie Clarkson calls the market at English Turn stable and above the national curve.
The inventory is down 22%. Less than it was last year, and 45% less than it was the year before. That's headway.
And while real estate experts expect the market to turn around in the next 5 or 10 years, they say New Orleans is one of the best places in the country to buy a home. On your side in English Turn, LaTanya Norton, WDSU, News Channel 6.
And real estate experts say another reason why there are so many homes on the market is because sellers are asking too much, while buyers are doing their research and becoming more educated.